listening for to stakeholders for or against as far as discussion?
Well, like I said in my closing remarks, I sincerely believe rural telephony is a must. What is in question is how do we go about it? Because as the service providers displayed this afternoon, they are not too enthusiastic about it because it affects their balance sheets, it affects their profit margin. They don't particularly like it. But this is to the detriment of Nigerians. That is why we must have a concerted and determined policy such that the 40-50% of Nigerians that live in the rural area have rural telephony. I asked earlier, I said, look, the way to understand the depth of pain that our people are going through, how do you feel when you lose your phone? When you lose your phone, it's like you are not a member of the world community anymore. So can you imagine, we now have people that has a lifestyle. They don't have communication, even for the most simple appearance or issue or businesses. They will travel long distances. When that travel time, the risk of travel, the cost of travel can just have been wrapped up in one short phone call. That is what we suffer in the rural area. And I'm sure this is the same all over the country. We need rural telephony. The manner in which we get to it is what we have to think about and arrange. Yes, we have satellites, communication and all that. But the truth of the matter is, even this rudimentary one, we have been at it now for 13 odd years, and we have not gotten anywhere. So why not do another 2-3 years, at least have this in the bag, and then we know we have option one, and maybe down the line, we have better options which we can then use. But what we have now, let's quickly put it together so our people can benefit from that process.
Chairman, yes I do. Rural telephony has been on for over 2 years. Yes, no idea. In the nutshell, what's the response?
Largely, I must confess, I think it's a lack of will and incompetence.
Incompetence.
How would a nation pay out for the $5 million in advance 10 years ago, and yet we have nothing to show for it today? Why just acknowledge that they have $14.7 million of Nigeria's money? I ask them, you have this money for 10 years. If somebody owed you for 10 years, in asking for your money, would you ask for interest? Excuse me. He prevaricated, but ultimately he acknowledged that, depending on circumstances, that will be the case. And I asked him, you have our money for 10 years, Nigeria's money for 10 years. Will you pay us interest? And he had no answer. But the truth of the matter is, they have not defrauded us. They have not defrauded Nigeria. Out of our incompetence, we have put ourselves in this bad position. These people are in possession of $45 million money, and there's no compulsion in returning it. After all, we have not asked them to supply, and they have defaulted.